Welcome! We arrived to our last episode of this How to Video series. In this episode, you will learn what type of data the camera creates and stores, and what options you have when to want to use this data for your own system. So, let's jump into it. We manufacture two main types of VIDAR cameras, a smart VIDAR with the ANPR module, and a simple version without the ANPR module. The non-smart version will not contain any ANPR data, it is only capable of sending the primary image and the trigger data from the selected trigger source into a desired FTP, SFTP, or HTTP server. However, the smart VIDAR models have more advanced event handling, and we will go through about it in details. So, let's see. On a smart VIDAR camera, once the camera finishes the ANPR process, it will automatically generate an event. By default, an event consists of three main aspects. The primary image in JPEG extension, which is used for the ANPR, a cropped license plate image in JPEG extension as well, and the last is the resulting XML or JSON extension data file, which contains all the information about the event. As a first step, we need to configure a destination server or application where we want to send the generated files. For that, navigate into the ANPR result upload section. Here, you will see a selectable upload method, but by default, it is disabled. To change it, just click into the field and select the desired method from HTTP, FTP, or SFTP. Let me mention that the HTTP method is capable to use the HTTPS protocol as well. For the HTTP and HTTPS connection, choose the HTTP method. Here, the camera only needs the hostname or IP address of the HTTP or HTTPS server, nothing else. There is an option to increase the maximum number of tries with the timeout of one attempt and the total attempts value with the max connection value. With slower network connection, it is highly advised to increase this timeout and attemptions value to a higher value. For the FTP and SFTP connection, choose either the FTP or SFTP field. Both methods will need the same informations: hostname or IP address, username and password for the selected connection, and the timeout and maximum connection attempts. Just fill these areas and hit the save button. After saving, the connection could be tested with the test button. If the settings were okay, and the camera can reach to the destination server, it will result in a protocol test was successful message. If the test was unsuccessful, recheck the settings and correct if it needed. Next, we need to decide what files we want to get via the configured method. In every selected connection, there is an upload content field. This field contains all the possible files which could be transferred. By default, the image has the primary image, the plate image has the cropped license plate image, and the result data, either XML or JSON file, are filled in. However, there are two more fields. The secondary image, which is the image attached to the event from the other sensor, if the camera is a dual sensor model, and the other one is the image strip, which is a combination of images connected to a specific event. It is only available when the image strip is turned on under the ANPR settings, primary source, create image strip section. Back to the event upload methods. Once we configured the connection and the desired files, one more thing left, and that is the desired file format for the resulting data file. As I mentioned earlier, it can be either an XML or JSON extension file, but it can be selected as well. Just click on the Configure Result File Formats Configure button, where the Template Editor section will appear. This section is responsible for the data file templates and file name templates. First, there are multiple file content templates by default, but of course in this editor you are able to configure your own. Just click on the Edit button on one template and enlarge the editor field to see what database contents it has. You can add more rows or remove unwanted rows as well. Once you customize it, just change the name and click Upload As. Then it will appear in the list and you can choose it with the tick button. Second, there is the file name template, which can be changed to a custom one as well, just like the content template. Make sure that the file name and content template extension is similar, namely, if you choose to have an XML content file, the file name should be XML as well. Once it is done, the camera will create the events and sending you the desired files to the setted connection. Without further ado, thank you again, and make sure that you subscribe to our channel and follow us on all social media platforms. Goodbye!